Hey everybody, the Bonga is back. Welcome to part 3 of Let's Play Shantae Risky's Revenge, brought to you by GameAnyone.com. Alright, it's time for us to continue on with this dungeon, shall we? At least I was able to save, and at least I'm right next to a save point in case things go wrong. Unfortunately, I still can't go underwater, so it looks like I might have to come back to this dungeon later once I have more abilities. Only to find more stuff. Also, why the hell am I riding Bowser's shell? Where did he get in this game? Oh, okay, so it looks like this thing just turns on its own. Thing is, it doesn't really turn the other way. So, looks like I gotta be quick. Ah, there we go, I did it. Go up here, or I can go to the right. Is there any reason to go this way? Other than getting gems? Can't really get up there. Alright, well, guess I'll just wait till I get the ability to climb walls. Pretty sure that's what I'll get at some point. Well, I know, personally, because I played this far when I had it on the 3DS. Well, it was originally a DSi game, but I didn't get it on my regular DS, I got it on the 3DS. Apparently, this actually has, like, more content that's a little bit more accessible. One of which, apparently, is the warp system that I did not know was revamped. Also, why the hell can I break that block, but nothing else happens? Okay, I still need a key. Maybe I'll find one on the way. Okay, well, I know to smash that block just to be able to continue on. Because I want to climb back up. Yeah, Shantae looks so done when she's crawling. Just look at her eyes when she crawls. Like, look. Okay, so these platforms pause whenever they get hit. So be sure to take that into account. That way you don't mess up your jump. Oh, hi. You again. Whoa, okay. Oh, jeez, their Trembler attack actually goes pretty far. Like, almost the entirety of the room. There, I did it. Those enemies aren't very tough. Just wait for them to put their shield away, and then you can fight them. Is this a boss room? No, it looks like a puzzle. I think I have an idea what I'm making. Dealt with a squid. So it looks like I gotta make a squid. These are the eyes. And... oh, wait, this is not a squid. I'm actually making what looks like a skull. Oh, okay. Oh no, not pumpkins. Now they're basic girls are just gonna make lattes out of them. Also, these platforms are a little bit low, so it's pretty easy to get hit by just colliding into the enemies. This must be where you get the key. Yeah, I thought so. Alright, now I gotta work my way back. Okay, these enemies take a little less time to kill. And there we go. Nice I was able to get, like, pretty good sized gems for each one. Aww. Okay. Patience has to be a virtue here. There. So far, so good. Haven't really run into much trouble here. And once I get this door open, everything will be hunky-dory. Yay. Who are these guys? Seriously? Oh god, their sprites are almost overlapping. It's crazy. Okay, so I'm almost finished with Metroid Samus Returns. And I must say that it is a really good game. I just wish there was like a little bit more of a need to backtrack. Because it seems like I'm try my best not to spoil it in case you haven't played it. But until you get all your abilities, don't bother backtracking. Unless you're struggling. It seems a bit of a disappointment to me. You guys are a jerk. I shall try my best to be more careful against those enemies. Is it safe to go down there? This is gonna be a bit tricky to pull off. I think I can drop down safely. Yeah, it looks kinda intimidating with all the spikes, but don't worry. How the hell do I time it so that I can actually get on these platforms properly? Oh, there we go. Oh. Is that one gem. I hope I'm not short one gem when I'm buying something. I swear to God, that would make me mad. What's this? It's a fountain. Who approaches my magic fountain? I sense a restless energy deep inside you. Channel your passions and allow the magic to take shape. I got the monkey dance. Simply hold the dance button and then release it during your first belly dance move to transform. The monkey dance will allow you to climb walls and leap to new heights. Oh, okay, that's actually pretty cool. May fortune follow you in your travels. Oh, thanks. There, you literally become a monkey. You can't attack, but you can jump high, and you can climb walls. So, that'll open up a lot of the game. And not to mention, you're a little bit shorter as well. So in case you need to get in a deep boss, because you can't crawl and jump at the same time. I'm just gonna wait for you to spit. Oh. How much do you spit? Like, seriously? I wonder I got hit. I was thinking, you know, maybe he'd be done, but no. For some reason, I can't climb these walls. Oh, come on. Okay, I guess you slide if you're not holding left or something. Or, you know, like holding into the block. Oh, that was dumb of me. How tall is this climb anyway? I feel like there's something in there, but I'm not gonna take the chance. That seems like a very tricky jump to try to pull off. So I'm not even gonna bother. There's a lot of gems over there. Why can't I break that block? Seems like that one didn't really matter. Whatever. That's a thing, but okay. I'll delay my attack. And I just got the full health. Sure, let's go this way. This looks like a secret passage for gems. Can't climb ceilings, apparently. Wait, I think I can climb this. There we go. Oh, get under there. Oh, well, I guess I'm not going that way to those, bosses. But I got this! Magic jam! Oh, the delay got me again. Looks like I can't really do much until later on. But at least now that I got the monkey dance, I can explore more places. Seems the only real reason to come here was to get the dance. And now that I have it, things should open up. I'm trying to think where that would be a good spot to look. Jump. I'll remember to have that dance ready. I think there was a spot over here. Or was. Oh, yeah, it was probably further down. Oh, I can't reach it here. Okay. I'll go the long way then. Oh, apparently you can't transition while transformed. Fair enough. Oh yeah, it was a spot. And we can finally get this! Another magic jam! I think you can trade these for stuff. So I'll try to find as much as I can. Really, thinks that would be a wise choice, all things considered. Try to secure a lot more money, even better. Where can I take you today? I'm at Tangle Forest right now, so I don't think I can select it again. Let's go to Lilac Field. No, I meant to say yes. Remember, there was something I would have to jump up for in order to get something. And now that I got the monkey dance, I can probably go get it now. Is there something in here? Oh, I can't really do anything with that anyway. Alright, let me just go back here. Man, this corn is so tall. Where is it? It's probably further to the right. I saw a chest that I could not reach. What is on this screen? Oh, all of a sudden I'm back here again. Was there anything else I could have gotten had it not been for my jumping ability? Maybe in here? I was already here and got everything. I just need the key, which I don't have. Yeah, I don't think I should make that jump. Maybe I passed it, or I'm going the wrong direction. Let me try going back this way. Yeah, there was definitely a chest that I could not reach. Might be in the opposite way of where I went. Let's go check to the left, up here. Yep, this is the spot right here. Heart holder. So that actually gives me 4 heart containers instead of 3. Wow. It's actually really good. I feel like there's more into this dungeon, but obviously I can't explore all of it yet. Left the towns of Pumpkin Field, out to the red lilac field, trying not to get lost. Alright, should I go to the Pumpkin Field right now? I might need to. Just in case. Well, let me go to the shop first. Welcome to the item shop. Yay. You know what? Silky cream. Prepare split ends for faster whipping. Ooh, I think I want that. Track magic allows you to track dropped items like a magnet. Your magic meter refills automatically. Ooh, that could be good too. Let me get the fireball for now. Oh, apparently you can upgrade it too. This requires 50 gems and a magic jar. Let's just get the pike ball for now. And I'll get the storm puff. I think I'm gonna save up my magic jars until I get another one for the silky cream. I think that might be the best choice, all things considered. Import room. I have to look into that at some point. It doesn't seem like it's gonna be any use to me. Just yet. Nobody's here. Huh, that's weird. Alright, well, let me go back this way. Probably won't get to see much because I still can't swim. Why are you here? I guess you were always here. You just asked me this. Why am I using all the exact dialogue? Wait, this is the spot where I got the egg. Oh yeah! I can get up there now. Yeah, lots of money. And I can go this way too, to Polyp Bay. Does not look safe. But I did it. Now I gotta do it again. I think I might need to stay a monkey for this. Good to know that I can actually climb these. Whoa! Okay. I'm, getting a little too bold. Here. But can I get everything here? I can't climb this stuff, can I? Nope, I can't. So I'll have to come back to that later. Okay, I was worried it would just go left on me. I think this is safe. Yeah, there we go. How long is this platforming section, anyway? Why does it have to be this long? God, don't fall off now. We made it to the next screen. Oh, good, a save point. Alright, am I right next to a warp? I have to go through another screen, and I say I'll make it. Wait, can I make it to that screen? Because there's water here, too. Okay, so apparently, right bumper allows me to use my magic. That's pretty cool, I guess. Was that? Yeah, it's morning. I remember in the, like, the original version, you had to find, like, two pairs of the same color of squid in order for you to actually use it as a warp. Kind of reminds me of Banjo-Kazooie. Hey, my third magic jam. This is my chair now. Okay, fine, it's not my chair. But nobody else is here, so whatever, I guess. You can take me to Lilac Fields. Looks like my objective is not that way, but maybe at Pumpkin Fields. So I think that's where I need to go now. Yeah, once I get this new upgrade for my attack power, or my attack speed, I will definitely take good advantage of that. So if I go to the pumpkin fields, how far do I have to go for warp? Not very far. It's like almost the next screen over. Alright, Silky Cream plus 200. Super Silky Cream. Max Hair Power. Okay, the speed is a little bit faster. I like that. Hi. I like how you say that and you still never bother to, like, say anything new. You do you, I suppose. Just have to do this on my own. A strong, independent half-genie that ain't no lamp. I'm gonna stop here, and in the next part, we're gonna go to the pumpkin fields. See ya, everyone!